Shalom.
Shalom, y'all.
What you waiting on? Under the weather. Yesterday was the Sabbath, and probably still sound a little nasally, but I did not go to Shabbat service yesterday. I rested in. So today, mind you, we don't shop on Shabbat anyway, but Friday night, I started getting sick. Josh was running a fever.
We were supposed to go grocery shopping Friday night, but it wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, Josh was really nasally. And so, the mind, I think, was more...
Exhaustion.
Exhaustion.
And stress.
Just, yeah. And then, too, I feel like I am trying to come down with something, but... because I've been drinking like alkaline water and stuff like that, I feel like it ain't as bad as it could be. Plus I took elderberry, which is what I gave Josh. My mom makes this elderberry tea and all types of tonics and stuff. So, my mom makes all these kind of tonics and teas and stuff. So I've been partaking in that. So shout out to her. Yeah, so now we're finally getting an opportunity to go to the store. We need to do some grocery shopping. So today, we're going to show you our haul and all that we have to buy to feed a family of six.
For 1 week.
Better not be 1 week.
Maybe 8 days.
Yeah.
8 days a week.
It'll be longer than that. I mean, the good thing about it is that we still have stuff left from our last grocery haul. Like, we're not down to the bare minimum, because sometimes that does happen.
We're out of coffee, though. That's an emergency.
We are completely out of coffee, but I'm not waiting. We going to Panera, and I'm going to get me a cup of coffee. Babe, you know, he gets in his feelings about having to buy coffee, you know, like from Panera. We don't do Starbucks, but he gets in his feelings about going to get coffee from Panera, and but we gonna drink it today. He gonna learn today. I mean, what's the other option? We're not gonna drink McDonald's coffee. We're not gonna drink,
you know me,
we're not going to Dunkin' Donuts. Their coffee is garbage.
I drink gas station coffee.
Here's the thing. We're coffee bougie. Like, we are coffee bougie for real. We like strong, good quality coffee. It doesn't have to be expensive. It ain't got to be like Kopi Luwak or something crazy like that.
I don't know what that is.
Babe, you don't remember Kopi Luwak?
No.
The bird poo? The
bird poo.
Not the bird poo. The monkey poo.
Bird box.
Cat poo coffee. Remember?
No.
Off of the movie with Morgan Freeman and... and Jack Nicholson.
Read it. Kopi Luwak is the world's most expensive coffee. Though for some it falls under the category of too good to be true. In the Sumatran village where the beans are grown lives a breed of wild tree cat. These cats eat the beans, digest them, and then defecate. The villagers then collect and process the stools. It is the combination of the beans and the gastric juices of the tree cat that give Kopi Luwak its unique flavor and aroma. You kidding me?
Cats beat me to it.
No, I ain't gonna turn it off now. Because you want me to turn it off.
Okay. You should know that by now, you really don't annoy me as much as you think you do. And then much as you try to.
But you be showing it, though. Unless you be faking it.
Who? I don't fake it. At all. I don't have to. Thank you. You literally try to antagonize me just so I'll get mad enough to sock you in your arm. Is that what it is? Is your arm itching? Well, why? Why must you antagonize me?
That's the way I am. That's just the way I am.
Pat-Pat at work.
Hey, Pat-Pat! Pat-Pat's at work.
So is Jaden.
I see him all the time.
I can't wait till we get our other vlog camera.
You don't like mine?
I love your camera.
Oh.
I'm just saying. Just to have...
So, did you know, not to cut you off, but while I'm thinking back, because I saw the bank, the bank down in Talladega that our assembly bank's with is opening a location by the Quintard Mall.
Really?
The old McAllister's.
Really?
That is a good location for a
bank.
It
is. It is. It's an even better location for a really good restaurant, but...
If I had the money, we'd buy that Hardee's building and open one. Because that's an excellent location.
It really is. They have ample parking and everything.
You just need some good food up in there.
We would be the ones to do it. Because these folks don't really know how to cook down here.
Not no Hardee's and Carl's Jr.
I guess we can go to Publix first. And check out the BOGO item.
Okay.
And then we're gonna go to Sam's. And then we're gonna go to Aldi, and then we'll be done. Is that okay?
Ain't she pretty?
Who's pretty?
You pretty.
Thank you.
You got a pretty mouth.
What is wrong with you? Get some coffee.
Can I turn it off now?
Yes.
All right, bye.
Prepare to whatever it is. She would go to you know, her little produce place. And then she would go. That's clean. See that?
Yeah.
And then she, you know, she would have all these different stores that she would go to and save money. You know,
right.
Now, because we live out in the country, basically, right? It might not make sense for us to do a long travel.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? To go from store to store to store, because by the time you do that, you'd be ate up your savings and gas.
Right.
But
yeah, just to touch base, we just came out of Publix and we just a little shocked because, you know, if you ain't shopped at Publix, they have BOGO deals every week. Buy one, get one. And I don't think we've ever came out of Publix. We had, 25 items and didn't even spend $40.
No.
So, now we hit it over to Sam's.
And let me just say this. I wish I knew, and that might be something I could do now that I'm at home working, you know. But I've always wanted to learn how to do extreme couponing. And Publix is one of those places that I've seen a lot of extreme couponers. They come in there with their calculators, their binders, and all their little hookups, and they're literally coming out of there maybe paying $2 or $3.
Right.
You know, for 2.5 carts full of groceries.
I remember one day a dude had a full cart, and the only thing he ended up paying for was his bottle of wine.
See what I'm saying? That's what type of time I want to be on. Like, I want to do that. But I want to learn how to do it. And I know that there are certain sites, because I have been doing some research on it, and I know there's certain sites that you could go on and pay a little bit of nothing and get a coupon subscription to where they give you the coupons that you need in order to get the savings that, you know, you're looking for. So, but I'm really interested. I'm intrigued by that. I really am. But, so right now we're on our way to Sam's.
So we have lovely drives. Well, yeah, we just finished all these. So we hit Publix, we hit Sam's, and we hit Aldi's.
Yeah.
So now we are headed home.
Yeah, I just got to make one stop. I got to go.
CVS.
To CVS real quick.
And then we're going to get home. We'll get it all spread out on the table.
And we'll do a haul.
And do a haul and show you what we got.
See, this is what makes me excited about the spring.
The buds on the trees?
Yep. The trees are flowering.
These are called redbud trees or dogwood trees. Depends what you want to call them.
Right. We got a couple in our yard.
Hmm.
Well, the one that you wanted to cut down?
If it don't bud, I'm cutting it down.
Mr. Lumberjack? Come on, folks.
Well, they bucking.
Let's drive. Let's do this.
They bucking a U-turn, so.
I know.
Hey, baby.
Okay.
All right. Well, we'll give you an update of what we got when we get to the house.
All right. Nummies. All right.
Ready when you are.
All right, so welcome back.
We finally made it home.
Yeah. We got a lot of stuff. I'm eating discount candy from Publix. Don't ever go grocery shopping hungry, because you make all the wrong decisions. So we're gonna start from Aldi and work our way to Sam's. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys our haul, babe and I. Anyway, so first and foremost, we got 6 Super Roll. This is a selected size Boulder Ultra compared to Bounty. These are some really good thick paper towels we got from Aldi. We also have 12 mega size rolls, which is equivalent to 48 regular rolls, and they could probably be compared to, who would you say, babe?
Charmin.
Mm-hmm. We have 2 loaves of split top wheat bread, Aldi. A snack combo pack, and this is original barbecue, sour cream and onion, nacho, ranch, and cheese curls from Aldi. We have cheese here, and we have just another bag somewhere. Anyway, we'll come to it. We got cheese here, we got sugar-free French vanilla creamer, sea salt pita chips, Parmesan garlic and herb pita chips, because over there somewhere is some hummus that we found on sale at Publix, which we'll get to that. We have meatless, the Zesty Italian vegan meatless meatballs. We have 2 cucumber. We have 2 bags of chicken nuggets, a ranch, beef tamales. These things are slamming, y'all. All you gotta do is, because they come in the corn husk, so you take them out of the packaging that they're in, put them in a Ziploc bag, and put them in the microwave, and it kind of steams it, and you know what I mean? They are so good. So those, we got two heads of cauliflower, as you can see. Babe is going to crumble up some of these to put on salads, and then I'm gonna also make mashed cauliflower, which is one of my new favorites. It's keto friendly, but we'll get to that too at a later video. Two applesauce. Here's the other cheese. Two of the kombucha. One is Ginger Aid and one is Trilogy. These are probiotic drinks. Very, very good, especially when you're doing keto. And just in overall health, we have two cans of fire roasted diced tomato. We have 1 pound of unsalted butter, 1 gallon of 2% milk. This is Black Forest turkey breast, Kraft cheese, 1, 2, 3, 4 chicken pot pies, chocolate almond milk. I said non-stick spray, olive oil, non-stick spray, bananas. Trying to get all the odd stuff, y'all. We have 2 cans of basil, garlic, oregano, diced tomato. We have 2 cans of tomato sauce. We have 2 boxes of crispy oats, honey nut crispy oats. We have 2 boxes of fruit rounds. We have a bag of mandarin oranges over here. We have a bag of pure cane sugar. Bag of mini avocados, spaghetti, turkey pepperoni.
Yum.
If you saw our family pizza night, that's one of the things that we used on the pizzas. Turkey pepperoni, really good. We have blueberry bagels. We have cinnamon raisin bagels. Lemons. I said the mandarin oranges. Roasted vegetable round crackers. They are so good. And I'm gonna make some tuna salad. We'll have that for lunch one day this week. We have 4 boxes of shells and white cheddar, macaroni and cheese. But a little one, he loves that. I'm also gonna make spaghetti squash one day this week. We have spaghetti. 2 jars of pasta sauce. Y'all know, if y'all watch the vlog, I use the jar, but then I doctor it up. So this is a tomato, onion, and garlic. And then this is a tomato, basil, and garlic. We have that. Now, that concludes Aldi. Now let's get to Publix. And one of the reasons why we went to Publix is because we like to check their BOGO items, or as Babe said earlier, buy one, get one. So they have amazing savings. We saved $30 just in Publix alone. So let me show you what we got. These yummy Sour Patch Kids, right?
With no gelatin.
No gelatin. They have no gelatin in them. And they were regularly, I guess this bag was $3.49. But this was on sale at $3.49. But then we got an additional 50% off, which made it half of this. So $1.34 or something like that. We ended up paying for it. I got 2 of the Bumblebee Chunk Like Tuna and Waters. They were buy one, get one free. We got 2 8 o'clock coffees. This one is Dark Italian Espresso, because we like our coffee strong. In case you guys didn't catch the other vlogs, we love strong coffee. It smells so good. So we got that one, and we got Caramel Macchiato. So that's going to be yummy for in the morning. We also got Buffalo Hummus.
Yum.
Medium heat. Like I was saying, we got pita chips from Aldi to go with this. This is normally probably like $3 or $4 a container. But we got them buy one, get one free. So.
Well, 2 for $5.
Or 2 for $5, I should say. I'm sorry. And then we got the buffalo one, and we got black beans. And then we have, and this is This is a refrigerated bag that I got from Publix for free when they first opened the store. And this thing comes in handy. Because I don't know, many of you who might not follow our blog just yet or whatever. In my old Aldi haul, I don't know if I mentioned that for Aldi, you have to have, you know, you purchase bags. That's, you know, to add to the savings. Obviously, you get a cart, 25 cents, you get it back. And you purchase bags and you recycle the bags. And so that's what we do. So a long time ago, when the Publix in our area opened, they were giving away these cooler bags. So this comes in handy, especially today because they have buy one, get one free Fat Boy ice cream sandwiches. I am recording. So we got two Fat Boy minis. They're 110 calories. The kids, you know, it's 9 sandwiches in one box. So that's why we got the little ones. It's just a snack. You ain't supposed to be getting full off ice cream and stuff like that anyway. But you shut up then, though, didn't you? You shut up then, though.
Be quiet for ice cream.
Quiet.
I thought y'all was talking about him with the plates.
No, I'm talking about you and your big mouth. Right. They also had, how much were these, baby? Were these about one get one?
Yeah.
So these are turkey.
So they came out to like $1.09 a piece.
Right, brown and served. They had the patties. Hello? 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 Hey. Hello? Hello? Up on there. All right, so we got two of the patties, which 8 patties come in here, the turkey sausage patties, and then we got 4 boxes of the turkey sausage links, which is 10 comes in each box. Hold on, man. All right, so like I'm saying, we got 10. It comes 10 to a box, so we got 4 of these. They also had buy one, get one free, which this never happens. This is the So Delicious dairy-free ice cream. We have cashew milk. This is the cashew milk one. And it has dark chocolate truffle. This is good. It's a good alternative to dairy-free ice cream because most of them are soy-based. This one is cashew milk. And this one is cashew milk also. And they also have coconut milk variety. We've tried a few of them. The cookie dough one is not that good. So now we're trying the salted caramel cluster. I think we might have tried this one before. I don't recall, but I know this one is good. This one tastes like brownie. It literally has like brownie chunks and stuff in it. So it's a good alternative for people who don't eat dairy and want something like a sweet snack or whatever. I'm missing something, right? Or is that it for Publix?
I believe that's it.
Okay. All right. So on the Sam's. So Sam's for our family is an absolute definite. We have to shop at Sam's because, you know, we have grown boys and they eat a lot. They just eat for sport. So Sam's is a must for our family. So what we did, and babe, he's started making this new little breakfast trio that he makes. It'll be like cheese, eggs, and potatoes, and this chicken sausage. This chicken sausage, the casing is beef collagen casing. And they use like organic ingredients, like organic cane sugar and stuff like this. And this sausage is amazing. This is the spinach and Asiago chicken sausage, but they have a sun-dried tomato and another flavor that they offer too. But this goes a long way. Like we can probably, how many would you say you cook?
4 at a time.
Like about 4 meals. Yeah, so it's about 4 meals in this package alone, just by itself. And then we also have the organic baby spring mix. And sometimes we'll eat this by itself, but sometimes babe will cut up some romaine and mix it in with this just to add a little bit more texture in our salads. And so this is like $4. And this is, you know, organic. And Walmart, places like that, it would be double that. So that's good. Then we have this big big bag of fish sticks. So this is fish sticks that we got from Sam's. We have, I'm not gonna lift that, baby, but this is the two of these big 1 gallon size of 100% apple juice. And so this goes a long way when the boys are not being lazy. And you know, usually they drink tea for their beverage of choice around dinner time. But when they being lazy, they want to drink up all the apple juice. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right. We have these little bites. Joshy likes these for a snack. He'll have, sorry about that, babe. He'll have these with like some apples or strawberries, or he'll just eat it by itself with his little chocolate almond milk. So we got the blueberry ones, and we have the chocolate chip ones as well. You see, I already went in and gave him a bag already.
He saw him come in the door.
He said it'd make his throat feel better. But anyway, we have waffles. We have top ramen. The boys, it's like a staple again. You know, they can come in after school and that's their little snack that they eat in between. You know, they'll come home from school and dinner. So they'll eat that. This is Babe's creamer. I don't use this in my coffee. I use sugar-free creamer in my coffee. Babe likes this creamer. I forgot why.
Well, because liquid creamer has soy in it.
Right. So there you go.
Men shouldn't have a lot of soy.
Right. Very good, baby. So, and then I started using this fabric softener. This smells so freaking good. I don't know why I never used this before. And it's very inexpensive in comparison to like a Downy or a Snuggle. Okay.
And it's very thick.
Very thick. And, with boys playing, you know, sports and stuff like that, it just helps keep the clothes fresh longer.
She's trying to be nice. They stink.
So this big container right here was like $9.98, okay? And then we got the game, which was on sale, right?
$3 off.
$3 off. It was instant savings. And then we have the ground turkey. This is 5 pounds. It's 2.5 and 2.5. So with this, I can make 2 meals. So one will be like for spaghetti or chili or whatever, and the other one will be like for a meatloaf or something like that. And so that's what we'll have. But we don't eat a lot of red meat. Every now and then I'll make like a roast or beef stew or something like that. Or like the other day I made like beef stroganoff, but I try not to have us eat a lot of beef. So, and then we have this turkey bacon. Mm-hmm. Y'all, this is the bomb turkey bacon. This is the best turkey bacon that I have ever had, okay? True story. I was in Philadelphia. For those of you who don't know, I lived in Philly for 8 years. And in my time there, you know, as a chef, I worked for a large hotel chain. And as I was working there, there was down the street from there was Reading Terminal. Y'all Philly folks, y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. But those of you that don't know Philly, if you ever visit Philly, you have to go to Reading Terminal. Reading Terminal is like the melting pot. They have eateries and stuff in there and all types of little produce markets. And it's just like a tourist attraction, basically. And it's in downtown Philadelphia. Anyway, they have Amish eateries in there and different little delis and stuff that they have in there. And this Gottschall is one of the families of Amish that actually was there when I was there. I don't know if they're still there, but they have some of the most delicious baked goods and butcher shops and like little eateries in there. I found out about this turkey bacon from there. And here, years later, I go into Sam's and I see this bacon. And I'm like, I know y'all sent me to buy this bacon because we like to eat, you know, breakfast meats in the morning. And we don't want to eat nasty cardboard turkey bacon just for the sake of saying we eating bacon in the morning. And this is just, this is awesome. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to tell you another thing that kind of ticked me off. Cracker Barrel, they used to carry this bacon. Babe and I started a trend. We went in there, we would order cheeseburgers with this bacon on it. So we have bacon cheeseburger. Don't you know they stopped carrying it? So guess what we did? We stopped going. So there's that. But anyway, again, I did buy some stew meat for beef stew, or, you know, I'm not really quite sure exactly what I'm going to make with it. Probably will end up being beef stew, but, so I got some stew meat from Sam's, and then we have this ginormous package of chicken thighs, boneless, skinless chicken thighs, and I can get two meals out of this as well. So, what I do is I just put them in a gallon size freezer bags, you know, and I separate them, and I do that by meal. But yeah, this is basically the haul. We have a case of water right here, 45 bottles for like
$339.
Thank you, baby. Yeah, so that's our haul. We did really well, I think. I'm tired now. Now we gotta put all this stuff up. Well, we don't, the boys do. So, let us know, comment below, if you guys like to see more of our hauls, because with our family size, we always going to the store for something or another. And yeah, just comment below and let us know if you want to see more hauls, what kind of hauls, if you want more information about some of these places that we go. You're not familiar with Aldi's, you can't beat it. They offer a lot of affordable options there. They have a lot of things that are vegan friendly. They got a lot of things that are vegetarian friendly. If you have a discerning diet and you are the type of person that like to eat a lot of organic stuff, they have a lot of organic stuff too. And it's not expensive at all. And so a lot of the stuff I have not tried yet. They're always offering new stuff. Every time we go in there, it's several new items that they offer. And so so we really appreciate y'all for watching our vlogs. Be sure to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Hit the like button and share. And make sure you hit the bell so you're notified every time we have a video. But we really appreciate y'all. And shalom.
Hit the bell button.